Chapman from LHP Productions. So first of all, this afternoon, I would like to thank you on behalf of the Epstein Theatre and LHK for coming. So it's our sixth year this year here at the absolutely stunning, amazing Epstein. And we're actually going to be bringing you a title, Peter Pan, that hasn't been staged here for 22 years. I think it was around 96, 95, the last time it was at the venue. So it's bringing something different, which obviously we always aim to do. And obviously with Peter Pan, with the fly-in and everything else, it's a very technical show, so there's a lot of exciting things to come. And obviously a great cast, very, very strong cast this year. Really, really excited to introduce you to them this afternoon. Peter Pan will be here from the 8th of December to the 1st of January. And I'm going to introduce you now to a gorgeous lady who will be starring in the show as Tinkerbell. She's from Radio City 2. And her name is Miss Claire Simmo. Please give a round of applause for Miss Claire Simmo, please.
Thank you very much. I feel like I might be a little bit typecast, but to be Tinkerbell here this Christmas, I just cannot wait. And the fact that Lee's just referred to me as a lady is even better, and a first. Obviously, the whole thing couldn't go ahead without of our sponsors, and we do just want to start by saying a massive, massive thank you to the Richmond Hotel, also to Love and Cake. You'll have seen the amazing cake when you walked in here this afternoon. To the Big Chocolate Fountain Company. I'm going to be looking out for you all to see who's got like chocolate all over them. We've been having a go at that later. Also to Four Seasons Catering, Millie Molly Mandy's Balloons. You used to read that when you were younger, didn't you? Millie Molly Mandy's Balloons, just love that. And also our charity sponsors, who are going to be with us right the way throughout the whole run. We've got the James at Bulger Foundation and the Chicks Children's Charity. So please give a huge round of applause for all of our sponsors and everybody with our charity sponsors as well today. Thank you. So you've met Tinkerbell, and it's now time for you to meet the rest of the cast. So I would like you to give a huge welcome this afternoon to who is going to be playing Tiger Lily, the beautiful Georgia Austin. Now then, Georgia, now you've been working with LHK for 5 years, played the role of Snow White here at Easter, training at Jelly Studios, and you've done theatre and TV work. This is a totally different role for you. How does it feel?
I'm really excited, to be honest. Last time I was a princess, so I feel really feel uncomfortable. Tiger Lily's quite a brave, a bit brassy maybe, so I'm really excited to try something different. So
a little bit feisty, bringing a bit of that to the stage, yeah?
Yeah.
Anything in particular, or anybody particularly looking forward to working with on this run?
I've worked with someone before, so it's really nice to be back with like friends and family always, but I'm excited to work with you.
Here we go, here's Tiger Lily, this is Georgia Austin, fantastic to have her back here after playing an amazing Snow White at Easter. Now, somebody who was just sort of arrived here today for the first time in Liverpool and has been overwhelmed by the way that she's been treated by everybody she's met, and she just said she can't believe how warm everyone is here. Please welcome Joan Harper, who's going to be playing Wendy. Now, we're loving this. We're thinking it's very sort of sandy, hopelessly devoted to you, aren't we?
Definitely.
Now then, tell us a little bit about yourself. What have you been up to then?
So I'm from Brighton, originally, and I trained at the London School of Music and Theatre. And yeah, I've been on a cruise ship singing for a year, and this will be my first panto. I'm really excited.
And Wendy as well. Now, I think that you're actually going to do a little song for us now as well, aren't you? Give a little bit of a taster of this amazingly talented young lady that we've got here this afternoon. I know that you're going to love her, so please, again, give a huge round of applause to our very own Wendy, Joan Harper.
Kiss goodnight, the way her father
by Joan Harper, going to be playing Wendy. And thank you to Ashley for accompanying her. Ashley's going to be our MD over Christmas as well, so really looking forward to working with him. Now, for those of you who are familiar with the pantomimes here, there is only one Dane that I want to bring out on the stage. He is so well loved. Everyone just knows that he is going to raise the roof with laughs. It is the one, the only, our Dame, Michael Chapman. You weren't going to come out then. You wondered who I was talking about, didn't you? Now then, not only have you got the joy of being on stage, you've got the joy of writing this, haven't you, Michael?
Is it a joy?
Yeah.
Is it a joy?
So tell us where you're up to with it at the moment.
About page 3.
Further than last year then.
I always get stuck on page 3 for some reason.
No, I can't imagine why. But as well as writing it, you directed it. It's a bit like, right, it's the theme tune, sings the theme tune, you know. How do you come up with something different every single year?
Well, that's a struggle, but this year I do think, you know what I mean, Peter Pan itself is totally different to, you know what I mean, it's not usually a panto, is it? I don't think it is, right? And, I'm trying to make it different this year. I mean, I've really worked hard on the jokes this year, honestly, so.
Have you got any to throw at us now? Just a little taster of one, I'm really putting you on the spot, aren't you?
Here's a joke for you, right? I don't know if you know this, yeah, I used to play the triangle in a reggae band, but I had to give it up because it was just one ting after another, wasn't it? That's not a good advert for the show, is it? You used to put me in a position.
Yeah, I know, you're talking about throwing you on the spot. But again, it's such a great cast, isn't it? You've worked with some people before, but we've all just hit it off.
Do you know what I mean? Usually we have like reality stars. There's no reality stars this year. Hey! That's good, isn't it? I'm looking forward to that. Like some of these can actually act. I'm not sure about Claire, but like some of them can actually act. I've seen them and they're good.
It is. It's going to be a real laugh. We can't wait to be working together. And you at the helm of it all. It's just going to be brilliant with you at the front of the ship. Michael Chapman, of course. If only I could say it, playing our Dane. Now then, you may have seen him here last year when he performed here, but now in the title role, what shoes to fill, bringing him on stage, a local guy, a cheeky chappy. I couldn't imagine anybody better suited to this role. The incredible Lewis Pryor as Peter Pan. That smile, you get away with murder. Could you imagine if you were his mum, you'd be like, all right, man, all his teachers and everything, you'd have got away with it, wouldn't you? Now then, this is your third Christmas panto with us here, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Tell us a little bit about you. Obviously, with your Britain's Got Talent, for those of you who don't know.
Yeah, I was on Britain's Got Talent. I was in Boogie Storm, who came there, so I do a little bit of dancing on the side as well. But yeah, this is my third panto here. I usually play the sort of funny guy, the comedy guy, but now I'm playing the title role, so I've got a little bit more pressure on me, but I'm sure I'll thrive on it.
Yeah, I mean, Peter's like sort of your cheeky chappy, but a bit cocky with it as well. Do you think you're going to pull that one off?
Yeah, I suppose I can.
And you're looking forward again, you've worked, because we've been at Jelly Studios and some of the cast that you've worked with before.
Yeah, so I'm training at Jelly Studios at the moment. I'm still in college, doing performing arts. I've worked with some of the cast before. I've worked with Georgia and Michael, of course, every year. Me and Michael have got a good bond, so I'm looking forward to being on stage with everyone and working with everyone again.
So who do you think is going to be the cause of all the pranks and everything backstage? Everyone's looking at Michael, aren't they?
Michael.
You see, I've got the innocent face, I can get away with doing bad things. Lewis, it's an absolute delight to have you as Peter Pan this year. You're going to absolutely smash it flying to Neverland. A huge round of applause for Peter Pan, Lewis Pryor. Now then, we are going to introduce to you our final member of the cast that you're going to meet this afternoon. It is somebody that I know that is going to bring this pantomime. I've got to say it because I can't help myself. He's going to bring it to another level. It is the one and only Dane Bowers! I couldn't resist that. That was a shocking joke, wasn't it?
It was bad. But it was better than Michael Chapman.
I love getting a bit of a thing wrong. We're just out of our mind waiting for you. They're all coming in. Now, this is the first time, actually, that you're waving your hook around, you're playing a bad guy.
It is. I've done one panto before, and I was Prince Charming, I loved it, but I'm actually happy that I can get legitimate booze now, and it's fine.
Yeah, are you getting into the whole baddie character then?
I'm good as a baddie, I think.
You're going to give us a little bit of your hook voice then?
No. Do you know what? I haven't decided which hook I'm going to be. There's been some really good hooks, like film-wise and stuff. So I haven't decided how I'm going to take it.
Oh, he's been a very mysterious hook. But you are going to sing for us now, aren't you?
I am. I've got to follow Wendy and Joan, which is going to be hard work. But and I've never actually sung this song dressed as a pirate.
Yeah.
Although I have sung it dressed in makeup and tights. Yeah.
Well, I'm sure we've probably seen that on the internet somewhere.
We'll give it a go.
Thank you for doing our
beat. There we go, Dane Bowers.
I can't laugh at
everything. Let me lick you up and down till you say stop. Let me play with your body, babe, make you real hot. Let me do all the things you want me to do. Tonight, baby, I wanna get freaky with you. Baby, don't you understand? I wanna be your nasty man. I wanna make your body scream. You will know just what I mean. 24 karat gold, the one that made you grow cold. See, I wanna lick you up and down.
Each and every one of us have turned up here today. Thank you so much to Jane on wardrobe, who has done such a fantastic job with these costumes. Also to Jade for putting everything together, behind the scenes being running around. To Ashley, I was going to be our musical director. Obviously to all the theatre staff as well. But most of all, I would personally like to say on behalf of all of us, thank you so much for Lee Kelly for bringing us all together, because we just know we're going to have the most amazing Christmas, aren't we, guys? Thank you, Lee. He's probably ran away now going up there. Just to let you know that we are going to be coming out to get some photographs out in the foyer, so we're going to be making our way through rather than doing them on the stage. There's sandwiches, there's cake, so we'll come through and do that there, and we'll see you in just a couple of moments. So ahead of it, a very Merry Christmas, and we'll see you on the 8th of January. Thank